These architecture animations are fun. We've done famous buildings like the White House, Burj Khalifa, and Buckingham Palace. I'm thinking it's about time we visit the Eiffel Tower. In this video, we'll look at the construction of the tower, the floor layouts, the elevator systems, stairs, and also the very top of the structure. That's all coming up. To visit the Eiffel Tower, we'll be heading over to Paris, France. Construction of the Eiffel Tower began in 1887, and it took over 2 years to build. The tower was to be used as the entrance to the World's Fair in 1889. It really didn't have a purpose other than to impress and prove that the engineering could work. The structure was made of iron and crisscrossed beams so that the wind could pass through it. Not everyone liked the tower at first. They thought it would ruin the beauty of Paris. And in fact, the plan was to tear it down after only 20 years. Long story short, it's still here, and it's hard to imagine Paris without the Eiffel Tower. Over the last 130 years, they've done their best to maintain as much of the original structure as possible while keeping it safe for millions of visitors every year. Let's make sure we appreciate the enormous size of the Eiffel Tower. From up here, the people below look like tiny ants. Before the Eiffel Tower was built, the tallest structure in the world was the Washington Monument at 169 meters. The Eiffel Tower was almost twice as tall at 300 meters. It was the tallest structure for 40 years, until the Chrysler Building was finished in 1930. But once the antenna was built on top of the Eiffel Tower, then it was once again taller than the Chrysler Building. But by this point, the Empire State Building was the tallest. In recent decades, there's been a lot more competition to be the tallest. Now, modern skyscrapers are all designed with computers, which makes the process much easier. In the 1800s, they didn't have any of that. It was all designed on paper. Now that's some serious skill. The tower has three floors, all of which are open to the public. The first floor has three red buildings, which contains a theater, restaurant, shops, and places to learn more about the Eiffel Tower. Towards the center, there's a glass floor around the edges that you can walk onto. I hope you're not afraid of heights. The second floor has two decks for sightseeing. There's also the Jules Verne restaurant, which can be accessed by elevator from the ground floor. The third floor is much smaller and mostly for sightseeing. On the bottom deck, you can see out through the windows or come up the stairs to the open air. Gustav Eiffel actually built his private apartment up here. And the very top is the perfect spot for television and radio antenna. So how do you get to these three floors? The first and the second floors you can reach by elevator or stairs. The third floor is only accessible by elevator. The River Seine is along here, and this is north, east, south, and west. There are elevators in each of the four pillars. The east and west pillars have visitor elevators. The north pillar also contains a visitor elevator, but it's currently being renovated. The south pillar contains two elevators, one for the Jules Verne restaurant and one freight elevator for the tower staff. The elevator tracks go on the inside edge of each pillar. The main visitor elevators are double-decker elevators, which go up and down at a slant. After you buy your tickets, you go in at the base and get on at the top or bottom cabin. Originally, it was intended for passengers to sit down during the ride. But today, the elevators only have standing room. You can get off at the first floor or keep going up to the second floor. What's interesting here is that the angle of ascent gets steeper from the first to the second floor, so the passenger cabins must adjust for that. The machinery for the elevators is hidden underneath the base. You can even take a tour and see this up close. Of course, if you're looking for a little more of a workout, you can use the stairs. The tickets are actually a little cheaper too. The south pillar is the one with two elevators. The one on the left is the freight elevator that's only for those that work at the tower. The elevator on the right is for the Jules Verne restaurant on the second level. You can get in on the ground level and ride it directly to the restaurant. To reach the third floor, you have to change elevators. In the very center of the tower, you'll find more of the structure that supports four more elevators. They work in pairs to balance each other out. And they are completely vertical, unlike the other elevators we've seen. When the Eiffel Tower was originally opened, one elevator would take you halfway up, and then the passengers would switch elevators to go to the very top. Nowadays, one elevator ride takes you the entire way. There are also stairs up to the third floor, but these are usually off-limits to the public. My name's Jared, and I create 3D animations to show and explain how things work. Head over to my YouTube channel to see more animations just like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.